What's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name, of course, is Trey Quintero. I'm here with a review for Bryan Lee O'Malley's Seconds. This is like an additional cover because I got it from Barnes & Noble. So I guess they're giving out jackets for it, which I could really care less about. This is the cover that I got. It's the layout of the restaurant that the main character owns, which is, that's pretty cool, I guess, because there's a guy taking a dump right there. That was pretty funny to me. But anyway, I know that there's like Destiny and everything going on right now, but this is really good content and I really wanted to get a review out for you guys because it's really good. Alright, so my first concern with Seconds was, you know, how are you going to top Scott Pilgrim? Because, you know, when that came out, I just connected with it. It was great. The movie came out. I loved the movie. Did terrible in the box office. Doesn't matter. I still love everything that is Scott Pilgrim because he's like every guy, right? He's like every nerdy dweeby dude. You can just relate to him. So I was worried about how you're going to top Scott Pilgrim. It's like, how is J.K. Rowling going to make anything after Harry Potter? It just seems really difficult, and it seems like you're setting yourself up for failure. But that's not the case here. I'm really glad about that. So one thing you will notice when you pick up this book and you start going through it is that it's a different story. It's about this girl named Katie. She owns a restaurant. She's a chef. She does really, really good work. But she wants a different restaurant. She wants another one to kind of feel like she can grow a little bit and break away and let someone else run her restaurant, which is called Seconds. And she wants a new place called Katie's. And so she's just trying to do all this stuff and get everything right, but she feels like she's failing and she's letting everybody down in one way or another. And so what you get here is that it's not a sequel to Scott Pilgrim narratively, but it does feel like a sequel as far as like tone and atmosphere and like the message goes. It's definitely, it feels like something that's matured and grown as you've grown. If you've read Scott Pilgrim, I think that you'll associate yourself with Seconds as well, in that you, I mean, because I was, as a kid, I was like, I didn't care, just wanted to have fun, whatever, hang out with the friends. That's kind of what Scott Pilgrim was. You're just kind of there, and you're not really, you're just kind of wandering around. In Seconds, she has more of a direction, but it's like, she's got, you know, all these balls in the air trying to juggle and then take care of everything and everyone, and it, you just feel like you let people down. You know, it's inevitable. So it does feel like it's grown with you. So that's pretty cool. I think that's a neat little aspect to it. So Katie has her first restaurant that she's at right now called Seconds, and she's trying to get her other restaurant, Katie, started up so that she can, you know, grow and work on her culinary arts or whatever. And so she's got a lot going on, and she feels like she's letting everybody down in one way or another, and she's making all these mistakes, and she can't help. That's just inevitable. And she feels really bad about it, and it turns out that she finds a little notepad and a mushroom in her drawer, and the notepad says, write down your mistake, eat the mushroom, go to sleep, and then you'll wake up a new, like in a new life. So she does that, writes it down, she eats the mushroom, and then she wakes up, and it's like the mistakes that she wrote down never even happened. So she takes, you know, serious advantage of this, because there's a lot of mushrooms. She just keeps, every day she'll eat a mushroom, she'll write down her mistake, whatever. And the next day, it's like she has a completely different life, and she gets a little out of hand with it, even though she meets this mysterious girl who's like warning her, like, you need to chill out, like, with changing, because, like, you're messing with existence, like, cause and effect, you're, like, destroying the stuff, and she's like, nah, I'm not really worried about it. She just keeps eating mushrooms and changing stuff, and so, like, the world and the universe is, like, bending and twisting because she keeps eating all these mushrooms, and she's changing the entire universe, and stuff gets pretty dark. Like, it starts out really light and funny. I mean, I guess you have to, you know, ease everybody into it, and it gets really dark. It gets really deep. Okay, maybe not super dark. It gets a little darker than, you know, something you'd expect from O'Malley. I had never got a chance to read Lost at Sea or the other work that he had, but it gets a little tiny bit dark compared to what we're used to from him, but it gets a lot deeper and it gets a lot more meaningful, I felt, than really anything Scott Pilgrim ever got to. So yeah, it's definitely a good piece of work, Seconds by Bryan Lee O'Malley. It's like 30 bucks, it's a little pricey for me. It is hardcover though, and it's full color every page, It looks really good and definitely deserves a place on the shelf. So I would pick it up if I were you. And if you've already read it, leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think. I'd love to hear from you guys what your opinions are. If there's anything else you want me to review, you can just hit us up on Facebook or Twitter. You can email me at rumblepackteam@gmail.com. And you can always check out what we're doing at rumblepackgaming.com. As always, my name is Trey Quintero. If you like this video, go ahead and sub for us down there and hit the like button. And thank you for watching.